everyone. This is Roseanne, and I'm here to share my all black lace book page for SpareMarbles, who is Diana. She's having an all black lace book page challenge for her birthday in March. And happy birthday, sis. I wanted to make sure I joined this one, and I am dying, I tell you, I want that book. Anyway, I have made my lace book page, and I wanted to make sure I'm outside, by the way. That's why you hear the, of course, dogs and airplanes and who knows what else. Anyway, I wanted to make initially a Moulin Rouge type of page for her. And then I remembered that she loved ballerinas. So what I did was I kind of mixed the two. Moulin or ballerina with a flair of Moulin. So anyway, I started out with a piece of a leopard print material, which is in the back here. And I wanted to have a lighter background so that you could have a little bit of contrast. And at the same time, there's lots of black in there. And once I laid the lace over it, it kind of concealed, except for on the sides here. And when you're close up, you're able to see the leopard print, as you can see there. But I got the bright idea of creating a ballerina because I know that my sissy loves ballerinas. And so I constructed her completely of wire and then wrapped her, made her little legs and her arms, which you're covered by the feather. Made her little arms. And then I made her little head there and her body. And then I created the tutu. So I wrapped the body with the lace, the black lace. I created the little tutu here and I made it really fluffy and added the little silvery glittered heart there. This is an applique, an old applique from laces that I got from Mozella quite a long time ago. Oops, I'm sorry. It's really bright out here and I can't see. So I made that. And then on her head, I put some sequins there. And behind her, I put feathers for wings. So that is the ballerina. The background is a beautiful, beautiful black lace glove. And this was given to me by my sissy June. Thank you, Miss June. And I just gathered it here and added this blingy ribbon that I have. I created a seam binding rolled rose and attached it to the end for like the cuff area. This material also, this bottom lace here that I used to cover the entire page was also given to me by Miss June, and it was a blouse actually, and I think I covered it up, but oops, there's some glue, that's nice. Here you can see that there's the button. It was down, was a blouse, a lace blouse. And this was like the buttons, the button area that I put on the top there. I also used more of this flourish that I used on the body. And I added some sequins there and there just to kind of finish off that top. I also added this little piece of black applique, and I purchased these from Shilpa, She was selling these black appliques last year or year before that. And I know that Diana said leave an inch, but there is room here, even though this goes over, there is room here for you to just lift up. And you do have an inch also with the finger here. There's room for you to work. This is the only area here that you won't be able to lift up, but I think that you'll do your binding probably in this general area, so there's lots of room there. Okay, and on the bottom I added this lace, which I purchased from eBay quite a long time ago. It's a really thin lace. And then this lace was given to me by Olivia. Thank you, Olivia. In her, oh my goodness, rack. And that was last year, but this is some lace that she gave me. And that's one of the, that one and this one are the only two black dangles that I own. This one, again, I bought from Shilpa. Oops, this lace here. And I tucked it under there, as you can see. And then this ribbon here, this satin ribbon, is from when I used to design for Carla's S001. I still have some of that satin ribbon left, or ruffle ribbon. And then again, there is my ribbon that I purchased quite a long time ago. That glittery ribbon. And then these are Prima Blings here. And this is part of this, the bottom of this, which is the other piece of applique that I bought from Shilpa. And this area is the area that I put here. I cut it up. So this was in the background there. I tried to make like a wallpaper type background. Sorry for the shadow. And then this applique I purchased from Etsy a couple years ago, and it was a store called A Thing for Bling. So I added that. I have been wanting to use this for quite a long time. And I do have two of them, so I saved the other one for my book. And so that is the page. Let me just set it down again. Hopefully you can see it in this light. I hope you like it, Diana. I had so much fun creating this for you. I wanted to make sure I made it unique and different. Now, I've been looking at all the other lovely ladies' pages, and oh my goodness, they are gorgeous. Okay, so this is the back. And, well, let's see here. Let me take the tag out. This is the tag, and again, I used, for the tag, I used just a piece of cardstock. It's got a key there. And then I have my information there, which you probably can't see. But I'm going to slip my information underneath. So, she'll be able to have it in there. That's why I left the bottom open. This is the other piece of the glove in the front there. That was a really long glove. So I use that to just slip the tag inside. on the bottom again, I used this gorgeous lace that I bought from eBay. And then I had this for a long time as well. Excuse me. And you know, you think you get rid of the glue strings and they always end up somewhere. Okay, Then this, I had a little bit of beaded trim. So I added some beaded trim there. And then again, this is the lace from Olivia. Gorgeous, gorgeous lace. And now you'll be able to see it better. Beautiful, beautiful lace. Thank you, Olivia. More of the ruffle trim. And then this is pieces from this. This is pieces from this applique again. And this was the bottom chopped off from the other side of the other page. And so there's more of that gorgeous ribbon, and then little black doodad flowers, and these were given to me by Nancy Martinez. Thank you, Nancy. So there's your tag, sweetie pie. And then the page, covered with lace. Again, it was that leopard print covered with lace. And now if you can look here, this was the button from the blouse. The button area, you know, where you button up your blouse, right there. So if you had your blouse on, it would be, you know, buttons here. I have had this tool in my stash forever. I made a Halloween project with this once, and a Halloween costume for my husband and I. Used to sew all of our Halloween costumes. And so I used a piece of this and gathered it up. I got some seam binding, and when you're working with black, you need to focus, or any monochromatic project, you always want to focus on textures instead of colors. So the glittery tool acted as a really good backdrop for that lace, or forward piece. And then this is seam binding here, black seam binding that I just tied in knots. 1, 2, 3, 4 knots. And then this was from this lace here, which I used to create the pocket. I cut out these little flowers and added them here. The other thing you want to do is be repetitive with your elements so that everything works together. And so this is a really nice pocket. She can put whatever she wants in there. And then here I just made a band, covered it in lace straight across, and then I added the feathers, the marabou feathers. And then these were rose appliques that I had purchased these from Gisella quite a long time ago. So I've had them for a while waiting for my book. So I put one there and one there. Let me see. This is a rose trim that I've had for quite some time. I'm down to my last few pieces. And it had gold leaf. And I was going to leave it. And then I had put a gold and black trim fringe. The one that Debbie just recently gave me. And it looked gorgeous. And then I remembered, nope, it's supposed to be all black. So I had to rip it up. Sorry, Diana. It'll go on my page. This is tool that I've had for quite some time also, and again, following the same element up here, I tied a knot here and here, which are, they're covered now. I tied a knot there, sorry, there and there. And then I had some black ribbon, old-fashioned vintage ribbon, in my stash, and I cut the little flower there and added it. And then these beads were on a beaded spray that my sissy, oh my gosh, I'm not even showing you, that my sissy Janet gave me, and they're on wire. So I just wrapped them up here, And then these are some, this is Prima Bling. This is off of some beaded trim, and this is off of some mesh trim from Natasha Scrap a Corner. And then down here, I used a piece of that, let's see if I can grab it, of that beaded trim, the little piece left here, and I attached it to the bottom of the flower so you have it dangle. I always have to have movement. Oops. So I thought that looked really pretty. And then on this side again, I have another one of those flowers that I cut. I used this trim again that I got from A Thing Is Bling, or a Thing for Bling. I don't know if she's on Etsy anymore. And then this lace here was part of my design team lace from Elegant Embellishments when I designed for Dee. Hey Dee, thank you. So I put a little bit here, and I like to break it up. I could have put it all the way across, but I think it looks better when you break up the style there. And then again, we have this gorgeous lace that I got from eBay, and then that's the back side. So there is my page, Diana. I hope that you can see it in this light, this sunny bright light. And your tag will go in here. I will have all my information down below. Let me pull this out and let me give you one last quick look here. And the front side. Okay. Thank you everyone for watching. Diana, I hope you love your lace page. I think I may have to make one for my mini album, and if I ever come to visit, you're gonna need to stash that book. I'm just saying. Okay everyone, thanks for watching. Welcome to all my new subbies. Welcome to COK, and God bless everyone. Stay tuned for more projects. Bye.